Hey everybody, it's Connie. I am going to show you how to put in an arrangement for orchids for Easter. First, you would need to have orchids, and this are the two orchids that I had regrow, and they start having all the buds and start blooming. And I get a bunny, and I should make a bow tie and some Easter egg. You can have anything you like. You don't have to have a bunny. You can have a chick, you know, or ducks and egg, or you can even have a cross or a reed, anything you like. And you would need to have something that big enough. It depends on how big the arrangement you would like. I'm just going to use two of my orchids. Cause this one, I have it, but it's already bloomed, and it will be kind of odd. Cause I want all, both of them blooming the same. And I get some moss to put over it, or to decorate over the top. And I had also make some ribbons that I'm gonna decorate. So let's start. So this orchid here, I'm gonna take out because it's smaller. And this one, since it's so big, it won't fit with it pot, so I'm going to put it in here. Come closer, show the pot. And because it's so tall, and I'm going to make it so look, this one need to have a stand, and let me make a stand of it. That way I need to figure out where do I want them to be so they can be, you know, together and look nice in an arrangement. I can do that. And then if you have a bigger, deeper vase, or you can use oasis or anything that you can put down. And then I'm going to put the rabbit. Don't worry about what this on the top gonna look like. So this will be my top, and I'm going to put the rabbit here. Make sure see stand it and that falling. And I had got some egg for Easter. This would be perfect for Easter, since we are restarting the Holy Week this week, and orchid will last the whole Easter season. So if you do flower, it's very nice too, but it won't last as long. So I have my orchids start blooming, so I thought of doing a quick clip to show you how you can decorate. Since this one does not have the moss yet, I want to put it in just to make it look like it's natural. You know, since it's small, I only need one, and I'm going to move this down a little bit. You space it out so it looks pretty. You want to make your arrangement as natural as possible. And you can put this, so that's pretty much it. And then I'm, look, so the ribbon, I'm gonna put this on top of this one and tie a bow. Just to make it a little bit pink, make like it's Easter. There you go. And if you want, you can add another one, but I think that would be enough, because you don't want to overdo it. You know, anything overdo is not pretty. And here's the rabbit, and now I'm gonna finishing it with putting the moss around it, cover the, it's okay that your root, some of the root showing, that's not natural, normal, but especially the one that you grow it yourself. And this are the two that had start blooming in my since I all my small one are growing. And you can even make it a little bit, you know, like it's falling down. That way it look natural looking. I love everything natural looking, look like it's natural grow like that, not like you try to fix it. Try to see, so when this grow, it will make the orchid grow nicer. Here you go, very natural orchid arrangement for Easter. So you can set this in your living room or wherever you wish that it's big enough, and it takes less than 10 minutes to fix, and it will last you the whole Easter season. And because this orchid, this buds, they will keep blooming, and they will last for months. Like this one right here I have, it's already been like 2 months, and it start blooming more. Look, one of the one is not good. See? So the when the bud fell off and it start blooming right here, it keep coming out. So this will last you probably 3 months for the whole Easter season. Alrighty, thank you. I hope you have a blessed Holy Week and happy Easter. Bye bye.